I hope you have seen my previous video on what is BERT. In this video, I explain how BERT works, the fundamentals of it. In today's video, we are going to do email classification, whether it's a spam or non-spam, using BERT. Now, BERT will convert an email sentence, you know, the whole email, into an embedding vector. So we saw in a previous video that the purpose of BERT is to generate an embedding vector for the entire sentence, and that is something that we can feed into our neural network and do the training. So here we will generate a vector of 768 length. Why 768? We have covered that in a previous video. And then we will supply that to a very simple neural network with only one dense layer, one neuron in the dense layer as an output. We'll also put a dropout layer in between just to tackle the overfitting. Now, if you open this BERT box, by the way, it has two components, pre-processing and encoding. And we talked about that in a previous video as well. So previous video, watching that is quite a prerequisite. So let's jump into coding now. Now here I have downloaded this file from Kaggle. Simple, two columns, category hammer spam, and here is the content of your email. I have imported a few basic libraries here in my Jupyter notebook, and I'm going to simply read this CSV file into my pandas data frame, which looks like this. And then I will do some basic analysis. You know, I will do df group by, let's say, category. So here I have 4825 ham emails and 747 spam emails. You can clearly see there is some imbalance in our data set. So we need to take care of that. But before we do that, we will create a new column in my data frame. You know, we'll call it spam. So let's create a new column. And if the value is spam, the value of this spam column will be 1. Ham, it will be 0. And you all know, if you want to create a new column in a data frame from an existing column, you can use apply function. And that will take lambda. And what you are doing is, if x is equal to spam, then the value is 1. You see, this is how ternary operator in Python works. Else, value is 0. And now if you do df.head, see, we simply create a new column. 0, 1. See, spam 1, ham 0. All right, so far so good. Now let's do train test split. So I'm going to use our standard sklearn train test split function, and in that my x is actually a message and my y is the spam, okay, the spam column. And I'm going to store the output into these variables. This is pretty much a standard practice in machine learning world. And okay, I will do test size to be 0.2. So 80% training samples, 20% test samples. Now let me check how it split the spam and non-spam. So value counts, okay. So I'm checking this to make sure there is a balance, okay. So let's see, okay, 149 divided by 967. Okay, around 15% spam in test and 3859. Okay, so it is good balance, but still, to be on a safe side, I will say stratify. So when you do stratify, it will make sure there is a balance, you know. It's not like in your training data set, if all the samples are 0 and there are, let's say, 2 samples which has spam value, then model will not be good in terms of detecting the spam. Okay, so that's why I supplied this stratify. I mean, before stratify also, it already did a good job, but this is just to be on a safe side. Now comes the most interesting part, which is creating the embedding using BERT. Okay, so how do you do that? So for that, you have to go to this TensorFlow Hub website and click on text and go to BERT model. Now in BERT, we are going to use this first model. So we saw in a previous video that there is an encoder and there is pre-processing step. So first you do pre-processing. So you click here, you copy the URL. Okay, so this is my pre-process URL. All right, and you go back, you go to text, BERT, and you go here and copy this URL. This is your main encoder. Okay, so this is your pre-processing URL and this is your main encoder URL. So I'm going to use Keras layer, hub Keras layer basically, okay, and call that BERT pre-process, and then I will use the same hub Keras layer here. And call it BERT encoder. See, we saw in a presentation there are two steps in BERT encoding, pre-processing and encoding. So that's what we did exactly. Okay, when you run it, it's gonna take some time because it is downloading the BERT model. You know, it's somewhat around 300 megabytes. So based on your internet speed, it might take some time, but essentially you are downloading a train model which is trained on all the Wikipedia and book corpus. So now in our task, we'll be just directly using that train model to generate the embedding vectors. After model is downloaded, I'm going to define a simple function that takes couple of sentences as an input and returns me an embedding vector. So basically the way I'll use this function is, okay, supply an array of sentences and any sentence, okay, and that should return me the embedding vector for the entire sentence. And if you have seen again my previous video, this pre-process handle that you get, you can use it as a normal function, and you supply your sentences here and it should return you the pre-process text. So I will just call it pre-process text, and then use the BERT encoder. Okay, and when you use the BERT encoder, it returns a dictionary out of which you need to use pulled output. Pulled output is basically the encoding for the entire sentence. Again, if you want to know what other elements are there in the dictionary, you need to watch my previous video. It's sort of like a prerequisite. All right, now see, when I run this, it is generating for this sentence, this is my embedding vector. The size is 768. For this second sentence, this is my embedding vector. So we have achieved the major goal here, which is generating the vector, you know, vector using the BERT. And I just give you a simple function, but in reality, we will be using TensorFlow layers. Okay, but before we go there, let me generate some embedding vectors. So for some more, you know, words, let's just generate it for words. Let's say banana. I want to see what kind of embedding vectors it generates for couple of fruits. And then, you know what? I will compare the fruits with Jeff Bezos and Bill Gates. So these three are people, these three are fruits. So let's see what kind of embedding vector it generates. And now I have all these embedding vectors, right? So if you do E, 6 by 768, okay, I am going to use cosine similarity. So if you have seen my cosine similarity video, if you do cosine similarity, you'll find this video where I have explained, you know, what is exactly cosine similarity. So if you don't know, watch it. It is used to compare two vectors. So here I will compare, let's say banana's embedding vector with grapes embedding vector. Now this takes a two-dimensional array, so I'm just going to wrap it up in a two-dimensional array. Okay, you see 0.99. so if it is near to one, it means these two vectors are very similar. So banana and grapes are similar because they are fruits. Banana and Mango is also similar because they are fruit. But let me compare banana with Jeff Bezos. It's kind of weird, right? Comparing banana with Jeff Bezos. See, 0.84, but still, they're not 0.99. They're not as similar as banana and grapes, okay? And by the way, you have to use this with a little caution. I mean, cosine similarity is not exact vector similarity, okay? So sometimes you might see some unexpected result, but that's okay. Now, let me compare Jeff Bezos with Elon Musk. See, again, 0.98. So you get the point behind BERT now. Okay, now let's build a model. So far, in our deep learning series, we have built TensorFlow models using sequential model. Okay, we are going to now use functional model. So there are two types of model, sequential and functional. Okay, so what is the difference between the two? I'm going to link a good article here. So in the sequential model, you add layers one by one as a sequence, you see. But in a functional model, you create your input, then you create a hidden layer, let's say, and supply input as a function argument. Then you create hidden one, then you supply that into hidden two's argument, and so on. And then you create model using inputs and outputs. Now this allows you to create a model which might have multiple inputs, multiple outputs, like something like ResNet. You know, you can also share network layers with other models. So there are some differences. You read the article, you will get an idea. So here I'm going to build a functional model. Okay, so the first step is you create your input layer. The shape is going to be this because the sentence length is varying. And my data type is string, and name of this layer, I will call it text or input, whatever. You know, you can give it the name that you like the most. And this will be my input layer. Then we are going to do this, these two things. So here I supply input, okay, same thing. And then BERT encoder, and BERT encoder takes, let me just do output here. So outputs, okay, and from the outputs, I get pulled output. So pulled output will be the sentence encoding. So pulled output will be this, okay. This I need to, I will create one dropout layer which I have not shown in the picture. So let me feed that pulled output into a dropout layer, and then last layer will be one neuron dense layer, okay? So let's create dropout layer here. Dropout layer is used to tackle the overfitting. Sometimes even if you don't do it, it's okay, it helps. And in that dropout layer, you pass this as an input, okay? So now I'm going to drop 10% of neuron, okay? And I will call it this dropout. And let's call it L. L is the layer. And the second one is the dense layer with one neuron. And since it's a binary classification, you know, like 1-0 kind of thing, I will do sigmoid, and the name of this layer is output. And again, we are using functional API, so you need to treat this as like a function and pass in the previous layer here. And then I will say override the same variable, you know, okay. And then in the end, my model is nothing but this model, which has two parameters, inputs, outputs. Now the inputs will be this. So it's an array, you can supply multiple inputs as well. So here, this is the input, and output will be L. Okay, and you can do model.summary. Okay, output is not defined. So outputs. Great. Now here my trainable parameters are 769 because I have 768 neuron here and this one. So total 769. My non-trainable parameters are so much. So these are the parameters from my BERT model. BERT is already trained, so I don't need to train them again. And when you are doing, you know, model building, you know that you do model compile, where optimizer loss, these are like pretty much standard things that we use in all our tutorials. Loss is binary cross entropy because we are doing binary classification here. And then I'm going to now run the training. So model.fit xtrain ytrain epochs. Let's do 10 epochs. Now this is gonna take time because the whole encoding process is a little slow and we have so many samples. So based on your computer, it might take time. I have a powerful computer and GPU, but still takes few minutes. So you have to be a little patient. You can reduce epochs if you want, okay? So I reduced epochs to 5 and I got 93% accuracy. Then I do model.evaluate on my X-test, Y-test. I got 95% accuracy, which is good actually. So now I do inference. So I have a couple of emails, actually it's not reviews, it's emails. And on that email, when I do predict, see, the first three emails are spam. The second, the rest of them are not spam, they are legit emails. And in sigmoid, whenever the value is more than 0.5, it means it's a spam. And it is less than 0.5, it means it's not a spam. So you see, so these things worked out really well for us. All right, so this tutorial provided you a very like a simple explanation of how you can do text classification using BERT. You can use BERT for variety of other problems as well, just such as movie review classification or name entity recognition. And by the way, I have an exercise for you, and the exercise is actually very simple. You have to just do copy paste. So go to Google, write TensorFlow tutorial, and in that, go to text tutorial and look at classify text with BERT. So what you need to do is, you need to just run this code on your computer. So just copy paste these lines, you know, step by step in your notebook, and just run it and try to understand it. This tutorial is similar to what we did, but the data set is much bigger. They are using TensorFlow dataset API. So in terms of API also, they are using a little different. We use pandas, and they are also using some caching. The model is also a little different. So if you practice this, you will consolidate your learning from this particular video. So I hope you're going to practice this. I trust you all, you're a sincere student. So please open a notebook, copy paste these lines one by one, try to understand it and see how it works. If you are confident, you can just load the data set and finish rest of the tutorials by referring to this page, but without referring to this page, okay? So thank you very much for watching. I will see you in the next video. If you like this particular video, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends.